I hope everyone can hear me, and I want to thank everyone for having us here. So, and I apologize that I can't read this in Portuguese. I hope it translates. The winter sun was barging in on me at a populous lunch counter. The coffee in front of me was piping hot as they dropped it. The steam was getting lost in my long hair and the idle chatter that surrounded me. The place was buzzing with secretaries on their lunch break, all wearing sensible shoes and ordering light lunches. My sickness was subsiding as the drugs were taking hold. I had the feeling of being hidden as I reflected from behind cop-style sunglasses. Safe in my head, my eyes were in the darkness like two vampires tucked in their coffins waiting for the night. The bent sunlight was hitting the counter, giving even the smallest crumbs long shadows that pointed to me. Getting a refill from the waitress, I felt the presence of someone sitting next to me. It was a schoolgirl with a tiny nose and a Catholic skirt. Her legs weren't long enough to touch the ground as they dangled and tangled with the stool that held her up. She was remarkably sexy because the flow of opiates that ran to my head momentarily ceased and yielded a much more lustful rush. But she sensed not all was right with the man sitting next to her. He was dying from the inside and looking to take someone with him. I dropped a dollar on the counter and lifted myself from the chrome and vinyl perch that held me up and headed to the door. Lower Broadway was suffocated with last-minute shoppers on this last day before Christmas. Wide-eyed tourists held their rosy-cheeked offspring tight as the wind ripped through us all and mocked my inadequate attire. I turned my collar up and noted the only piece of luck I had today was that the wind blew from the south as I headed north. My hair swirled in front of me with the snow that blew past. I could feel the wetness of the flakes that melted on my cheeks. I took two Xanax from my pocket and separated them from the lint ball they were joined with, swallowing them with my own spit. Right as boxes of three-card Monte games tumbled and fell, its players scattered in separate directions, lost in the flurries. I turned right on Halston and trudged on to my cocaine bodega that laid beyond. This is my white Christmas, I thought, dropping a 20 on the counter for coke. Getting back to my apartment, I moved through the cold darkness of my surroundings to the kitchen table to start the formulaic ritual. I hated the holidays and hated myself even more during them. My roommate was away with her family, as was everyone I knew. My family knew of my overindulgences, my excesses and passions for the medicated arts. A card with her name on it was as close as I got to them. Yeah, they left me cold like a limp handshake, but I didn't care, so I thought. I had Frosty the coke dealer and Rudy the red-nosed smack dealer to keep me warm. The rest of the day consisted of pills and powders and the means in which to get them. The streets were empty each time I went to re-up, so empty that I recognized my own footsteps in the snow. This continued for hours as I stumbled from one shadowy doorway to the other in the late day sun. It was at that point, with a head full of delirium and spinning like a medicated dreidel out of control, that I stepped into Avenue B in the path of a taxi. Everything slowed down in the moment and the second before I was hit. Sobriety bitch slapped me into reality, and the taxi threw me into the air. I landed yards in front of it. Before I passed out, I had time to notice there wasn't another car in sight. The streets were empty except for the car I stepped in front of. What were the odds? I woke later that night, flanked by white hospital curtains and a tube in my arm. My nurse, Michelle, wore a name tag adorned in mistletoe and garland. Merry Christmas, she said cynically as she snapped off her surgical gloves and moved out past the curtains, revealing two cops on the other side. They turned the radio down from their belt and headed towards me. Yeah, I thought, Merry Christmas to all and to all a good night. Thank you.